invite everybody to be seated. If there are any other children who are in the congregation who would like to come forward for the time of reflection, I would love to have you up here. I'd also love if any of our baptismal families feel comfortable doing so, if one parent would bring the newly baptized up to join us as well. It would be helpful to have you in our midst as we're reflecting on what just happened. Tanya, if you don't mind joining us too, that would be great. Today, we just celebrated a really special occasion. We believe that our lives become joined to Jesus. And we believe that Jesus shows us God. So if we are close to Jesus, then we are going to be close to God. We know what Jesus cares about, then we know what God cares about. And if we follow Jesus, then we will be clothed in God. So that's exactly why I asked my mom this week to make this chasuble. And she made this for me. I asked her to make this because we're going to start a new tradition here at St. George's, and this is going to be our baptism chasuble. So, do you see what's on the back of my chasuble? There's some writing on the back of my chasuble. What I did yesterday when we met to plan for today's baptism is I asked the parents, the godparents, I asked Tanya, I asked her sister Cheryl, to write on this beautiful piece of fabric. And I asked them to write a prayer or a blessing for the person being baptized. And every time now that we have a baptism here, we're going to add those prayers and those blessings and those words to this chasuble. And I hope that we'll get to the stage where this is absolutely covered in all of those prayers and these blessings. Can you read some of those words? Happy, good health, love, did you see love, example, joy and wonder, yes, absolutely. So all of these words give us prayers and blessings, ways in which we can show God to other people, that we can be clothed with God. Do you think that there are other words that we could have written? Are there other ways that we can show God to others and show God to the world? What do you think, Charlotte? We can write more prayers, yeah. We can fill this chasuble with prayers. We can be people of prayer. That's one way that we show God's love. We show God to the world. What else can we do? Owen. Sorry. Oh, we could put hearts on here. Is that right? Yeah, because when we're loving, then we're showing God to the world, we're clothing God. There are other things that we can do that help us to show there who saw Jesus raised from the dead, but there was one person who wasn't there, one of Jesus' disciples, and his name was Thomas. And so when he wasn't a bad guy, actually. Thomas was a very good guy, but Thomas sort of thought that when his friends told him that Jesus had been raised from the dead, he sort of thought, they're trying to fool me. That couldn't have really happened. And so Thomas says, unless I see it with my own two eyes, and unless I touch Jesus' hands with my hand, I am not going to believe. So you guys are trying to trick me. And so a week later, that's when our story takes place. Jesus isn't upset with Thomas for saying this, but Jesus comes and appears to Thomas, and he appears to some of the other disciples, sort of like angels, yeah. Except he says very clearly, I am alive and you can touch me just like that. And so Thomas believes, and the other disciples believe, and then they're given a job to do. And that job comes all the way to us here today. Because what would have happened if only those couple of people, Thomas and some of the disciples, who saw Jesus that night, what if they were the only ones who ever had an opportunity to believe in Jesus and to know God? What? Yeah, so Thomas was able to believe that God is love and kindness, but it could have ended right there. If those were the only people who ever got to see